It is a stunning day in Pasadena, California, as we welcome you to the 123rd Tournament of Roses Parade. The theme is Just Imagine, and it's hard to imagine a more perfect backdrop.
And what a lovely float this is once again from the folks there at Donate Life. The theme, One More Day. The folks that Donate Life, showcasing year in and year out all the good that can come from even the most tragic events through organ donation. And there are some of the families of those who have given the ultimate sacrifice. And the fluorographs behind them, pictures that are completely inlaid with organic materials, remembering their dearest and most loved ones. Among the 72 donors honored today, some names you might recognize: Christina Taylor Green, the 9-year-old, one of the 6 killed when a gunman opened fire on Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords and her constituents. Last year, there she is, Christina Taylor's mother, Roxana Green, riding on the float. Also pictured, Jovante Woods, the son of former Cincinnati Bengal running back Albert Icky Woods. At age 16, he had just gotten his driver's license, had just ticked the organ donation box, and now his heart beats on in another chest. They do such wonderful work, and because of things like this, this float, the number of registered donors has nearly doubled in the years that Donate Life has been involved in the parade. Now some 42% of Americans over the age of 18 are registered donors. And as the finishing touches were put on this spectacular and really so important a float, we had a chance to see how giving life forever changes both the donor's family as well as all the volunteers tasked with decorating these beautiful portraits.
My daughter, Katie Enos, died about a year and a half ago. She was hit by a car. And we decided, at her request, to donate her organs. On Katie's bucket list that hung on her wall, she wanted to save a life. It was one of the items on her list. And so we knew that in this way, she could save not one life, but many.
We didn't know what fluorograph we were gonna do. So when we got our packet and opened it up and saw that it was a young girl, it was really kind of emotional for us. And you know, we read her story and it brought us to tears just to read about her.
It's awesome to share this with my daughter, that she's been able to do this with me. I mean, we have a bond and a connection by doing this now. And it's been very special for us.
As soon as they created Katie's eyes and shook off the excess, suddenly Katie was there.
These people they're putting together an image of my daughter, one of the last images that will be made publicly of her. It was bittersweet.
To see Katie's picture get put up there all together, it was a really cool experience, and now she's, you know, at the top of the clock and right there for everyone to see her.
From Pasadena, California, this is the 123rd Rose Parade.
All right, coming up next is a very special float. It's the judges' special, Outstanding Showmanship and Dramatic Impact. This is timepieces from all over the world, as well as some very special members of the Donate Life family that are featured on One More Day. At the front of the Donate Life float, what has become a Rose Parade tradition, the Dedication Garden. It contains thousands of individual roses, each bearing a message of inspiration written by organ recipients or representatives of organ donors.
Everyone riding on this float and having a duet has a remarkable story. Right. Among the riders are the dad, the brother, and the mother of the little 9-year-old girl who lost her life in the attack on Arizona Congresswoman Gabby Giffords. This little 9-year-old girl had already decided to donate her organs if such a time should come. Tragically, that came, and they are here to support this effort today.
What a great story. What a beautiful float. And we congratulate the folks from Donate Life. They win the judges' special. The passengers on this entry are all either organ recipients or representatives of deceased organ or tissue donors.
And you see, the clock serves as a reminder that life is precious, too precious to waste even 1 minute. And the pictures you see here speak volumes, don't they?
Really nice.
Come into each house. And they really do a fabulous job.
And you got a realtor, so you got people competing.
Yep.
The realtor trying to list it and the decorator trying to get you to love it again to keep it.
Love it or list it. It's on HGTV. I hope you have a chance to catch it. Take a look at this float. It's called One More Day, and it's a beautiful float and a beautiful story. It's from Donate Life. They won the judges' special trophy for outstanding showmanship and dramatic impact, Jamie.
As they should, but this is an absolutely beautiful float for many reasons. One more day to remember a loved one, celebrate life, keep hope alive, and make a difference to others. Leading the float is a dedication garden honoring thousands of transplant donors and recipients nationwide, with rose vials carrying personal messages of love, hope, and remembrance. Over the past month, families of the donors depicted the florographs, the 72 of them. They came to Pasadena to decorate the portraits of their loved ones, which is just incredible. Look at those amazing florographs. Other florographs on the float were decorated by families who couldn't travel to Pasadena. And riding on the float is a donor mother. Her daughter, Christina Taylor Green, was the third grader who unfortunately passed away while hoping to meet Congressman Gifford in Arizona earlier this year.
You know, beautiful. And so many of these Donate Life volunteers help work on other floats, too. It's a great group. Yeah. We've just loved meeting them every year. So
3,000 roses on that float.
RFD-TV's broadcast of the Tournament of Roses Parade is being brought to you with limited commercial interruptions by...
Well, here's the judges' special trophy. And, of course, the judges' special trophy is most spectacular in showmanship and dramatic impact. And talk about Donate Life's float and their dramatic impact.
Indeed they do. And, again, the donation of human organs that I hope most of us indicate on our driver's license is again portrayed here in the Donate Life One More Day. And six floral clocks adorned with 64 memorial florograph portraits of deceased donors gave life to those in need. I received an email from one of our RFD-TV viewers that I do want to mention, telling us about a young athlete who died, but before he did, he had again signed the card to donate organs. And his heart went to a middle-aged man who has become the son of the family that lost.
Oh my
and,
goodness.
I mean, he made contact and he said, "Your son lives in my heart."
Wow, there are so many great things. You know, on the front of the float, there's a garden. And each of those flowers are put in a vial with a personal message. The Donate Life Float, One More Day.
Univision presenta El Desfile de las Rosas 2012. En vivo de costa a costa desde Pasadena, California.
Lourdes. Así es, señores. Done vida un día más. Este es uno de los mensajes más lindos que podemos ver en este desfile. El tiempo es oro, señores. Para quienes dependen de un trasplante de órgano o de algún tejido, pues el tiempo simplemente es vida. Mire, los seis relojes, ahí vemos uno de ellos, están adornados con 64 fotografías de donantes. Óigame bien, amigos, fallecidos, y 10 de ellos son hispanos, Poncho.
Qué importante es donar. Precisamente 28 personas que están a bordo de esa carroza, entre ellas 5 latinos, fueron beneficiados por la donación de órganos y tejidos. Ahí se encuentra Alex Rodríguez, que es hermano del boxeador Francisco Paco Rodríguez. Él falleció después de un combate y salvó la vida de 5 personas a las que Alex ha conocido.
Wow.
Qué importante es donar. En mi caso personal, se los digo, mi licencia dice que si algo me sucede, utilicen mis órganos para donación.
Claro que sí, y son muchos los que se ven pues beneficiados en este sentido. Mira, Juan Espino de Texas también está ahí, falleció su esposa y bueno, sus órganos de ella se utilizaron para salvar 8 vidas. Entonces es una manera de que esto continúe, de que la vida continúe y que se pueda pasar por lo menos este otro día más, ¿no? Que es el tema de esta carroza.
Pues
con este bello mensaje, ¿no? Nos vamos a una pausa y más adelante, Poncho, regresamos con este gran desfile de las rosas en vivo desde Pasadena, California, costa a costa, por su casa Univision. Ya regresamos.